Hello and welcome to the episode 45 of What a Fab Day. I am your host, Simon Mas. Today, we will fight to get a kiss, chill by a pool, and prepare to go to India with the Beatles. On the 14th of February 1961, the Beatles, with Pete Best on drums, performed at the Casanova Club and at the Litterland Town Hall, both in Liverpool. While it is interesting to know that the promotional material from the Casanova Club had advertised the Beatles as the originators of the atom beat, it is the special St. Valentine's Day event at the Litterland Town Hall that bore more light on the future exploits of the band. During the performance of the new Elvis's hit Wooden Heart, Paul McCartney wore a big red satin heart on his coat. The heart, signed John, Paul, George and Pete, was ruffled, with the winner also promised the kiss from McCartney himself. When the lucky girl jumped on stage to get her prize, many others from the audience followed her. In the resulting commotion, John Lennon was knocked on the floor and he, with the rest of the band, had to be rescued by the bouncers of the club. The performance was stopped, and it took a while for calm to be restored. In 1962, the Beatles, still featuring Pete Best on drums, performed an evening concert at the Cavern Club in Liverpool. Moving on to 1963, we find the Beatles playing at the Locarno Ballroom in Liverpool for a special St. Valentine's Day dance. This was one of those venues that had probably hosted some of the early skiffle contests and performances of the Quarrymen in the late 1950s, but it was the only time that the Beatles performed there, despite it being a well-known ballroom in Liverpool. At the time, the venue could host 3,750 people. Built in 1905, it is still standing today under the name of Olympia. On the 14th of February 1964, the Beatles were at the Deauville Hotel in Miami Beach, Florida, mixing work with rest, or rather, as much rest as possible with the rampaging Beatlemania outside and inside the premises. During the day, the band took part to a photo session by the swimming pool of a Capitol Records executive's home. The photos appeared in Life magazine. Later, the Fabs completed a TV rehearsal for their upcoming second appearance on The Ed Sullivan Show. A brief tour of the harbor wrapped up the day. In 1967, from 7 p.m, the Beatles were at the EMI Studios to work on Only a Northern Song, creating take 12 with reduction mixes and overdubbing two lead vocal tracks over that. By 12:30 a.m, after the production of three rough mono mixes and the relative acetate discs, the session was concluded. Finally, in 1968, assistant Moll Evans flew from London to New Delhi, India, bringing with him the luggage belonging to the Harrisons and the Lennons, for a trip that the whole band was about to take. The aim of the journey was studying transcendental meditation with Maharishi Mahesh Yogi, but for the moment, Evans had to pay £195, 19 shillings and 6, about £9,900 in 2020 money, for the excess luggage. This trip concludes today's episode of What a Fab Day. Please, if you liked the episode and you want to find out how you can help me to keep up the effort, visit www.simonmas.com/support. In the episode description, you will find the link to the bibliography of the podcast with its Amazon affiliate links. Making your Beatles-related shopping through them will help me paying the bills and spur me to put even more work in what I already do. For the moment, I wish you a good day and a fab continuation.
Simon Mas, music you love.